Hi students, happy day students. This session I am going to discuss about the important topics which is useful for NEET and JEE mains. So very important. Without this topic there is no question paper. So the points are aldol condensation, cross aldol condensation and intramolecular aldol condensation. So many students they are focusing only on the aldol condensation, but you should remember the cross aldol condensation and also intramolecular aldol condensation. Okay students, now you can see one by one what is aldol condensation, what is cross aldol condensation, what is intramolecular aldol condensation. After listening this session you can get clarity about the aldol condensation and you can answer any questions which is given in which will come in competitive examinations in 2021 NEET and coming JEE mains. Okay students, let's start. So first one, aldehydes and ketones which have at least one half a hydrogen atom. You should remember students, many students are confusing about this. For example, if you take acetaldehyde molecule, this is CH3CHO. This is called acetaldehyde molecule students. In this acetaldehyde molecule, this is called functional group students. This is called functional group. This functional group neighboring carbon atom is called alpha carbon atom. This is called alpha carbon atom. So the condition, it should be alpha hydrogen atom. Okay, this is the first condition for aldol condensation. Undergoes a reaction in the presence of dilute alkali. So here OH minus, that is diluted. You can take dilute NaOH solution or dilute KOH solution. This not only increase the rate of reaction and formation of the carbon ion, it will also increase the rate of reaction. That's why it is called catalyst. So initiate the reaction, as well as the meaning of catalyst is nothing but does not participate in the reaction and initiate the reaction. So it acts as a catalyst, dilute base. You should remember dilute base. If you have the dilute base, that is called aldol condensation. If you have concentrated base, that is called Cancero reaction. We will discuss about that in next session. So condition, you should remember, it should be alpha hydrogen atom. If you have alpha hydrogen atom and if you have dilute base, that reaction is nothing but aldol condensation reaction. Okay students, now you can see next one. So aldol, what is the meaning of aldol? You can see students, it is a mixture of the two names. One is aldehyde and one is alcohol. So you can see students, here aldehyde and alcohol, these two function groups are combined together. That's why this aldol contains aldehyde as well as alcohol function group. So aldol is derived from two functional groups, aldehyde and alcohol. You should remember this one. For example, if you take the example of this compound, let's take, this is your compound CH3CH, CH2CHO. So this compound, it contains aldehyde functional group as well as alcohol functional group. So it has both alcohol as well as aldehyde. That's why it is called aldol group. That's why it is called aldol condensation. Now coming to the point, if you have ketones, ketones combined with the impedance of base, it forms ketone. That means it has a combination of ketone function group as well as alcohol function group. So that gives ketone students. So here also we have the same name like aldol condensation. Okay, so for these reactions also we can apply the word aldol condensation. So these are the fundamental points students. Now you can see, I will give one simple explanation. 2 moles of aldehyde CH3C double bond OH in the presence of dilute base, it forms what? So like this, in examination, competitive examination, they will ask the question students. You can see here, this is your compound CH3 C double bond OH. Now it react with second mole of aldehyde molecule like this in the presence of base. So here what happens, you can see students, here that base initiate the reaction. How it initiate the reaction? It abstract the proton from neighboring carbon atom. It abstract the proton from this compound. If you remove this proton, this carbon get negative charge. So immediately it forms carbanion, students. Carbon having negative charge is called carbanion. CH2 minus C double bond OH. So this is carbanion, students. So it acts as a nucleophile, students. It acts as a nucleophile. And you should remember the word, aldehydes and ketones undergoes nucleophilic addition reactions. They undergoes nucleophilic addition reactions. So it acts as a nucleophile. And here in first molecule, that carbonyl group, this group is polarizable. So you can polarize the pi bond here. Here negative charge and here positive charge you will get. At negative side, this proton will attack, students. At negative side, this proton will attack. And before that, what happens, you can see, before that, this nucleophile is attached at electrophilic carbon atom. So you can write like this, students. CH3, CO minus H, CH2, C double bond OH. So here, this is the compound, student. This is one of the rate determining step. So you should focus on this one, nucleophile. It depends upon the nucleophile and carbanion. Okay. And here you can remember the word. This is your carbanion, students. Okay. Suppose if you have electron withdrawing groups here. Electron withdrawing group is here. Electron withdrawing groups increases the all-all condensation. If you have electron donating group, electron donating group decreases the all-all condensation. You should remember this one. Minus I group increases the rate of reaction, plus I group decreases the reaction. Why? Because plus I group is electron donating group. So this electron donating group, this electron donating group donates the electron to carbanion. So it becomes more electron rich, it becomes unstable. Okay, if you have electron withdrawing group, it withdraws the electrons and finally that carbanion becomes stability. You know, carbanions minus I group increases the stability. Okay, so based on that, so now here the compound is formed like this, students. So after this what happens? After this, here the proton which is attracted by the hydroxyl ion, which is attracted by the base removes the proton. You know that base is acts as a catalyst, so it does not participate in the reaction. So again it releases proton. And finally, your product is looking like this, students. CH3, COH, hydrogen, and CH2, for convenient, I am writing like this, CHO. So you can see, students, here, it has alcohol functional group and aldehyde functional group. This is called aldol, students. It has alcohol functional group as well as aldehyde functional group. So this is called aldol. So after this, elimination takes place, students. So for example, you can take next slide. I will explain here. So this is your compound, students. CH3, CHOH, and here CH2, and here CHO. After this, what happens? It is under the mechanism, E1CB mechanism, under the conjugate base mechanism, unimolecular conjugate base mechanism. It undergoes dehydration, students. So here indirectly elimination takes place under the mechanism E1CB mechanism. Finally it forms a unsaturated compound CH double bond CH C double bond OH. If you count the compound 1, 2, 3, 4, if you write the IUPAC name of this compound, this is nothing but prop 2-in-1-all. Sorry, students, it is 4 carbon atoms are there. So it is but 2-in-1-all. Okay. So here indirectly, if you consider it is alpha position and it is beta position, alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compounds were formed here. Alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compounds formed here. So this is about complete information. So first step, nucleophilic addition takes place, students. Here aldol compound was formed. From that aldol, after that, because of heating, elimination reaction takes place and finally form alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compounds. So this is about complete information of aldol condensation, students. So aldol condensation is nothing but carbonyl compounds having alpha hydrogen atoms react in the presence of dilute base to form aldol, and heating by elimination of water molecules, it forms alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compound. So this is about aldol condensation, students. See, the mechanism is given here. If you want, you can take this screenshot. It is useful for you. So same mechanism I have given here. Next one, students, I am going to discuss about cross aldol condensation. So what is the meaning of this cross aldol condensation? You can see, students, if two different carbonyl compounds are present, and which have alpha hydrogen atom, that carbonyl compound should be alpha hydrogen atom. But that carbonyl compound is not same. It may be one ketone or one aldehyde, or one ketones with a different and aldehydes with different, one aldehyde with one ketone. So if you have two different carbonyl compounds like aldehyde and ketone, or you can take any aromatic aldehyde or aromatic ketone, in the presence of dilute base, it forms mixture of aldol compound, students. So this is known as cross aldol condensation. Okay, so before that, I will give one short trick, you can see, students. So this is CH3 C double bond OH. This is one compound, students, and you can take CH3 C double bond O CH3. This is acetone, students. Okay, in the presence of dilute base, here I am giving the formation of the mixture of products. How I am giving one short trick, you can remember, students. So before that, you can identify alpha hydrogen atom. Here one alpha hydrogen atom is possible, here one alpha hydrogen atom is possible, here also alpha hydrogen atom is possible. So sure, they undergoes cross aldol condensation. Now you can see, students, you can write the carbonyl group like this. You can write the direct product, and where you have the alpha hydrogen atoms, you can write like this. So now you can identify, students. So now here you can remove the water molecule. So what is the resultant product? Your resultant product is CH3 CH double bond CH C double bond O CH3. So this is one indirect process, students, for identifying the product. One indirect product. I am giving here so one short trick, so please focus on this one. And now this is one molecule, this is second molecule. Now you can write the reaction between second molecule and first molecule, students. So I am writing like this: CH3 C double bond over CH3 plus CH2. You can focus on alpha hydrogen atom. I am giving one more time clue. So this is your C double bond over H. This is indirectly CH3 CH4. Now you can remove water molecule here, students. So I am writing the reaction between 2 and 1. So finally, in presence of dilute base, these are all in presence of dilute base, you should remember that point. So finally, what is the resultant product? CH3 double bond CH C double bond OH. So both are different, students. Above one compound different, below one compound different. So here, like this, here one compound and here second compound was formed. Now I am writing third compound, students. I have no space, so I am erasing here. So you can see, students. Now you can take itself, students. So before that, one molecule combined with other molecule. Now you can take aldehyde molecule between one and one, between one and one. This is your molecule CH3C double bond OH, and here also you can take hydrogen atom CH3C double bond OH. So between themselves you can write the reaction. If you remove the water molecule in presence of dilute base, so what happens here? What is the resultant product? Your resultant product is CH3CH double bond CHC double bond OH. So the product is different. This is the third product. Now let's take between 2 and 2, between 2 and 2. Okay, students, between two molecule and second molecule and second molecule, you can take a self alcohol condensation. So finally, what is the product? CH3CH2C double bond OH. This is second compound, and you should write alpha hydrogen atom C double bond OH in the presence of dilute base and heating. So this is one short trick, students. If they ask the question, you simply identify the carbonyl compound in first compound and hydrogen molecule in second compound and removed as water molecule, and finally attach the two bonds between carbon carbon atom. You can write double bond. So see, students, this is your compound. This is the two terminals, and simply in between them I am writing double bond. So this is the fourth product, students. Okay, so like this mixture of products was formed here. So you should focus on this one. So this is called cross aldol condensation. Okay, students, so we will get mixture of products. This is a short trick to identify the product. So this is about cross aldol condensation, students. Now let's look at next slide. So already we have discussed this example before. Now between ketone, this is the compound. This is cross aldol condensation, students. If you using two types of carbonyl compounds, both having alpha hydrogen atoms, we will get mixture of four condensate products. Let's look at this example, students. Two type of carbonyl compounds will give two type of carbanions, which will be nucleophile for itself and other molecule. So if you take two molecules, four different products are formed, students. You can write like this: between 1 and 1, 1 product, between 1 and 2, 1 product, between 2 and 2, 1 product, between 2 and 1, 1 more product. Finally, we will get the mixture of products. As I told before, you can focus on this one, students. You can focus on this one. As I told before, this is your compound. When acetone and aldehyde, both are different carbonyl compounds and both have alpha hydrogen atom, react with the dilute base, these four products will be appear. Let us consider acetone is the second molecule and acetaldehyde is the first molecule. Acetaldehyde is the first molecule. Between acetaldehyde, one product. Between acetaldehyde and one more compound, one product. And between acetaldehyde and ketone, one product. And between ketone and ketone, one more product. So like this you will get the compound, students. You can see here one. This is your ketone, students. Ketone, second molecule, that is nothing but ketone. Between ketone, one molecule is there. Between ketone and alcohol, aldehyde, one molecule is there. And ketone themselves, so once again I am repeating this one, students. Between ketone and ketone, what is the resultant product? So fourth product, once again I am repeating, you can see, students. So here I have taken the previous one, CH3 C double bond O CH3. This is second molecule, this is nothing but ketone. And you can take C double bond O CH3 CH3 in the presence of dilute base. So what is the resultant product? What is the resultant product? So for conveniently, you can write the alpha hydrogen atoms like this, students. And you should remember, you can remove the water molecule. Your product is CH3, C double bond, O, CH double bond, CH3 and CH3. Okay, so between ketone and ketone, one product. Okay, so like this, they will ask the questions. So you can focus on this one. Okay, this is about cross aldol condensation. Next, you can look at the cross aldol condensation. Here, I have the same examples. Like this is aldehyde molecule, students. Acetaldehyde molecule. This is acetaldehyde molecule. This is propanaldehyde molecule. Propanaldehyde, because both are different. Different aldehydes. Finally, you will get the compounds like this. So mixture of products was formed here. Mixture of products was formed here. Now you can see, students, aldol condensation between aromatic aldehyde and aromatic ketone. Now let's look at this equation, students. For example, if you have a aromatic aldehyde, this is called benzaldehyde, students. This is called benzaldehyde, and you should focus on this one. Here in benzaldehyde, carbon is surrounded by four bonds, so no alpha hydrogen atom here. Here no alpha hydrogen atom, you should remember. And it react with acetophenone, students. This is your acetophenone, C double bond O, CH3. So this is your acetophenone. Okay. So it has alpha hydrogen atom. Functional group neighboring carbon atom is called alpha carbon atom. So it has alpha hydrogen atom. Now here what happens? Alpha hydrogen atom is there. So you can write like this, alpha hydrogen atom. In the presence of base, so in the presence of strong base, base removes this proton and finally form carbon ion. And here polarization takes place, negative charge and positive charge. And finally the product is looking like this, students. This is CHO minus, and here you should attach hydrogen atom, and here you can attach the same compound. So for convenient, I am writing hydrogen this side, and here I am writing the compound, second compound, CH2 carbon ion will attach here, students, because here positive charge, here negative charge, proton is attached here. And C double bond O and benzene, like this compound was formed here, students. So this is the final product. This is the final product. Now after this, what happens, students? Because of heating, because of E1CB mechanism, so here water molecule will be removed here. So finally that resultant product will be water molecule. You can remove like completely CH double bond CH, here phenyl group is there, and here the C double bond O, phenyl group is there. If you want IUPAC name, you can write 1, 2, 3, because functional group is first priority. So your compound is 3 phenyl prop 2-ene. Okay, 2-ene and 1-one, and here first position and third position you have the phenyl group. So you should write like this, 3, 4 diphenyl prop 2-ene 1-one. So like this they will ask about this. This is also one example of cross aldol condensation. So if you have at least one alpha hydrogen atom, in that case this reaction will happen. Okay, students, so this information I have given here. This is 1, 3 diphenyl prop 2-ene 1-one. Okay, and this is the nothing but benzol acetophenone, students. This is also known as benzol acetophenone. You can remember this word. This is also called benzol acetophenone. Sometimes they will ask the question for IUPAC names. They will ask, what is the IUPAC name of benzyl acetophenone? You should remember. So between ketones, one of the component is there and aldehyde is there. In this case also cross halal reaction is possible. That example is given here. Okay, students. Now I am going to discuss about the intramolecular aldol condensation, students. How this reaction takes place. For example, if you have a compound like this, a C double bond OH, CH2, 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 C double bond O, and if you have the dilute base like OH minus. So in this case, so intramolecular means that reaction takes place within the same molecule. Within the same molecule, reaction takes place. Okay. So here in the presence of base, here proton is removed. So here carbon ion was formed. So this part acts as a nucleophile. One part acts as a nucleophile. And for conveniently, I am writing the numbering here. This is the first carbon, second carbon, third carbon, fourth carbon, fifth carbon, sixth carbon. Okay. So you can leave this carbon atom. You can write only fifth carbon atom. Why? Because, okay, you can write sixth carbon atom. So because here ring structure was formed, students. Now here polarization takes place. Here polarization takes place, students. So here negative charge and here positive charge was formed. So you can write the numbering. You can see the numbering between second carbon atom and sixth carbon atom. So between them bond formation takes place. Between them bond formation takes place. Otherwise you can write the numbering like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. You can erase the numbering now. You can start from carbon ion. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So here between 5 and first carbon atom we have the new bond formation, students. So this is first carbon atom, this is fifth carbon atom. 1, 2, 3, 4. And first carbon has C double bond OH. And proton is removed. So here first carbon atom have negative charge. And fifth carbon atom have positive charge. Between them reaction takes place. And that fifth carbon atom O minus is there. That O minus is attached by hydrogen and finally form OH group. After this, here hydrogen, proton and here hydroxyl ion is removed. Finally, we will get the compound like this, students. Here a double bond formation, here CH. So finally, we will get the compound like this, students. So if you write the structure clearly, you will get the unsaturated compound here, students. And that unsaturation is conjugated with this compound, students. If you write the double bond here, C double bond OH. So here conjugation is present. So alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compound was formed here. So this is your structure, students. So here what we observed in intramolecular aldol condensation, we will observe the cyclic alpha beta aldehyde or ketone in the presence of basic medium. This is the point. So this reaction observed in the same molecule which have aldehyde and ketone. Aldehyde and ketone within the same molecule in the presence of dilute base, it forms alpha beta hydroxy aldehyde and ketones. So this is about cross aldol condensation, students. Sorry, this is about intramolecular aldol condensation. Intramolecular aldol condensation. Okay, students, the same mechanism is given here. You can focus on next slide. So this is the mechanism. One more mechanism. I am writing the mechanism. You can see the given compound is looking like this, students. C double bond O, 2, here one bond, double bond O, like this. Okay. Now you can take, students, you can take shifting like this. Here negative charge and here positive charge is there. And you can focus on alpha hydrogen atom. You can focus on alpha hydrogen atom. So here alpha hydrogen atom is available and here alpha hydrogen atom is available. So if you remove hydrogen atom here, if you remove hydrogen atom here, I am giving one clue. You can focus on this one, students. If you remove hydrogen atom here, this negative charge and this positive charge, you can absorb four member ring structure, students. So that four member ring is unstable, students. That four member ring is unstable, right? That's why I am removing this sixth proton, students. Now you can see. So this is the identification of the bond, students. If remove the carbon atom here, double bond O, and now if you remove the hydrogen atom here, and here you get carbon ion. If you shift the bond like this, here you get positive charge. Now you can see, students, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 6 member ring is formed, students. So you can see, when compared to 4 member ring, 6 member ring is more stable, students. Why? Because it has less strain, so less repulsive energy, so it is more stable. But here 4 member ring, it is more stable. So 6 member ring was formed. You can see 6 member ring was formed. So now I'm writing direct equation, you can practice, students. So here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, I am giving the numbering. Now after this, you can see, after this, here at first position O minus group is there, that is attracted by O minus group is attracted by H group. And at sixth position and at the fifth position, you have the ketone function group, students. Ketone function group, you should remember this one. Okay, at fifth position you have the ketone group, and this is your compound. So after this first position, you have the side group, side one methyl group is there. You can see, students, here first position you have the side methyl group. So finally, this is the resultant product, students. Okay, so once again I am repeating the point. I will remove this point. Once again I am repeating, students, you can see, because here no space, that's why I am writing once again. So this is your ring structure, students. Now here that pi bond is polarizable, students. Pi bond electron is polarizable. So finally, this compound get negative charge, and here number 1, number 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Between 1 and 6, you can write the bond. This is 1 and 6. You can write the bond like this, students. I am using different color for understanding purpose. So this is your 6 member ring, right? Okay, now at first position you have the side group, methyl group. You can write like this, and it is surrounded by O minus, that is attracted by, that one is attracted by the proton and finally form OH group here. So this is about the point, students. And at fifth position, at fifth position you have the double bond O, students. So this is the compound. So after this, if you heat the compound, your hydrogen group and your hydroxyl group is removed. Finally, we will have the product like this, students. I will take the dark color, easy for you. Here a double bond was formed, and here methyl group is there, and here ketone was there. So this is unsaturation, alpha beta unsaturation compound, alpha beta unsaturation compound. So like this, you will get the compound, students. So this is it is nothing but intramolecular condensation. 5 or 6 membered ring alpha beta unsaturated ketone and aldehyde was formed here. So this is about complete information of intramolecular alkyl condensation, students. So they will ask the questions like this. So recent JE mains, they have given particularly about intramolecular alkyl condensation. You can focus on this one. And next one, this is one more example. You can practice this question. So this is about complete information of what we have discussed. Aldol condensation, cross aldol condensation, and intramolecular condensation, students. This is about complete information. So finally, I am giving some questions, you can see students. All condensation will not be absorbed in the following reaction. See, chloral, trichloroacetaldehyde students, this is a previous question, trichloroacetaldehyde and phenylacetaldehyde CH2, if you have the phenyl group here, and this is phenylacetaldehyde, and hexanol CH3, CH2, 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 you can write 6 carbon atoms, this is hexanol students, and ethanol CH3CHO, this is ethanol students. So they are asking which of the following compound does not give allyl condensation. You should focus on this one. This is a short trick. Which have no alpha hydrogen atom. Which have no alpha hydrogen atom. That compound does not undergoes allyl condensation. Which have no alpha hydrogen atom. That compound does not undergo allyl condensation. So here alpha hydrogen atom is there. Alpha hydrogen atom is there. And function group neighboring carbon atom, alpha hydrogen atom is there. In chloral, there is no alpha hydrogen atom. So this compound does not undergo allyl condensation, students. So like this, in NEET and JE mains, they will ask the questions. You should focus on this one. So this is your option. So you can focus on this one. Next one, which of the following gives allyl condensation? So you should identify the alpha position in the given compound. So here C6, this is no alpha hydrogen atom, students, and here also no alpha hydrogen atom, because your compound is looking like this. There is no alpha hydrogen atom here also, and here also no alpha hydrogen atom, because all carbon atoms are surrounded by methyl groups, and this carbon atom surrounded by carbon atom, no alpha hydrogen atom. Now you can see here alpha hydrogen atom is there. So this is your product. See students, this is your product. You can take screenshot, it is useful in future. Okay, so this is about complete information of allyl condensation. So I hope you understood this point, you got these points. So thank you very much students. Please like, share my videos. I will update everything and I will give NEET previous questions, how they are given in previous examination. You can subscribe my channel. Thank you very much, students.